Hello everyone, welcome you all on this online study platform. Today we are going to learn about unit 6 factors and multiples part 2. Part 1 is already uploaded, so you can, if you have not seen the part 1, then you can see to it, and after that see the part 2, then only you will be able to understand the things. In this unit we are going to learn about SCF and LCM. In part 1 we have discussed about factors and multiples, prime number, composite number, even and odd numbers. In this we are going to learn about how to take out SCF and LCM. So to find the SCF there are three steps. First step is find the factors of the given numbers. So if you have to find the SCF of any number, so first of all you have to take out the factors of that numbers, and then in second step you have to select the common factors from the given numbers. Means if you in first step whatever factors you have taken out, in second step you have to choose the common factors. Means in both numbers whatever the same factors are there, that will be the common factor. In third step you will choose the highest common factor. So whatever common factors you have selected in step second, you will choose in third step the highest of them, means the greatest one. Let us see the example. Find the SCF of 8 and 12. So factors of 8, we have already discussed in part 1 how to take out the SCF. How to take out the factors. Let us understand. To find the factors of 8, first of all, we have to see in which table 8 is coming, or from whichever numbers 8 is divisible. So first take the first number 1. 1 is, when you will divide 8 by 1, it will be divisible by 8 times. 1 is a 8. So it is divisible by 1 and how many times? 8 times. So when you will write 1 multiplied by 8, it will give 8. It means these two numbers 1 and 8 both are the factors of 8. Now after one see the second number, that is 2. After 1 2 is coming, so see whether 8 is divisible by 2 or not. So 2 is 8 is divisible by 2 by 4 times. 2 4 is 8. So in how many times it is coming? 4 times. So both numbers are the factors of 8. Now if you will take the third number, that is 3, so 8 is not divisible by 3, so 3 is not the factor of 8. After 3, 4. So 4 is divisible by 4, 8 is divisible by 4, so 4 is also the factor of 8. But here you can see already 4 we have written, so now we can see that the number is going to be repeated, so we will stop the taking out the factors. Means only these factors will be the factors of 8. It means the factors of 8 are 1, 2, 4 and 8. Now take out the factors of 12. First take number 1. 12 is divisible by 1. How many times? 12 times. So 1 into 12, 12. So both are the factors of 12. Now after 1, 2 is coming. In 2, 6 times 12 is coming, so both are the factors. Now 3, 4 is 12. So after 3, 4 is coming. If you will take 4, the 4 into 3 also gives 12, but you can see here already 4 we have taken, so no need to take 4 once more. So that is why we will stop if we see that the number is already with the other numbers. We will stop the multiplying the numbers. This is only the factors of the 12. Now the factors of 12 are 1, 2, 4, 6 and 12. Now so we have taken out, first step we have done, that we have taken out the factors of the given numbers. The factors of 8 are 1, 2, 4, 8, and the factors of 12 are 1, 2, 4, 6 and 12. Now in the second step we have to take out the common factors. Common factors means whatever the factors are same in both the factors, that will be the common factors. Now see, 1 is in both, so 1 is the common factor, we will take 1. Now see, 2 is also here is also 2, so 2 is also the common factor. Now see, second is 4, next is means, so 4 is also the common factor. Now no factors are common, means only 1 to 4 here, these only factors are same, these are all the common factors. Means common factors of 8 and 12 are 1, 2, and 4. Now second step we have done. In third step what we have learned? In third step we have learned to take out the highest. You can see the third step, choose the highest common factor from the common factors. Now we have taken out the common factors, that is 1, 2, and 4. In this the highest one is 4. It means the highest common factor of 8 and 12 is answer 4. Easy? I hope you all understood. Now, in your book some questions are given. Question number 1, is 7 a factor of 63? If you have to tell about any number that is the factor of this, that 7 is a factor of 63 or not, so what you will do, you will divide 63 by 7. If 63 is divisible by 7 exactly means completely without leaving any remainder, then 7 will be the factor. Now see, when you will divide 63 by 7, the answer will come 9 and remainder will be 0. So we can write clearly 7 divides 63 exactly, therefore 7 is a factor of 63. Understood? Now second question, show that 14 is a factor of 1246. Both are the similar questions. In first it is asked whether 7 is factor of 63 or not, and second it is asking show that 14 is a factor of 1246. In this also we will do the same solution, means we will divide 1246 by 14. So solution 2, let us divide 1246 by 14. So divide 1000, I think you know how to divide. 1246 divide 14. 14 is a 112. Now do minus. Now 14, 9 is 126. So it is divisible by how many times? 89 times, and the remainder will be 0. So we can write clearly, on dividing 1246 by 14, we get no remainder or we get 0 remainder. It means what? It means 1246 is completely divisible by 14. Hence, 14 is a factor of 1246. I hope you understood this. Now you can see here, solve examples, some given in your book. Example 1, is 11 a factor of 1034? So it is shown here. What we will do? We will do divide here, division. We will show in copy. If you will write in copy, one side you will show the division. You can see clearly here, remainder is 0. It means 1034 is divisible by 11. Here it is written clearly, 11 divides 1034 exactly. Therefore, 11 is a factor of 1034. Example 2, show that 15 is not a factor of 1309. So how will you show it? Again, you will do divide. You can see here divisible is done. The remainder is here 4. It is not completely divisible. It means it is not the factor of 1309. It means 15 is not a factor of 1309. I hope you all understood this. You can solve this type of questions from your book. Next is how to find LCM. So here are 3 steps. First, find the multiples of the given numbers. Multiples we have learned in part 1, how to take out the multiples. So you will take out the multiples of the given numbers. In second, select the common multiples. Common means इन बोथ द मल्टीपल्स, वॉट एवर मल्टीपल्स आर सेम दैट विल बी द कॉमन. एंड इन थर्ड चूज द अकॉर्डिंग टू इट्स नेम एलसीएम, फुल फॉर्म इज लीस्ट कॉमन मल्टीपल. लीस्ट मीन्स लोवेस्ट, लीस्ट मीन्स लोवेस्ट. सो द लोवेस्ट मल्टीपल विल बी योर एलसीएम. नाउ लेट अस टेक द एग्जाम्पल. फाइंड द एलसीएम ऑफ फोर एंड सिक्स. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फाइंड द मल्टीपल्स. अकॉर्डिंग टू स्टेप वन वी विल फाइंड द मल्टीपल्स ऑफ फोर. सो मल्टीपल्स ऑफ फोर इज फोर. फोर टू ज़ा एट, फोर थ्री ज़ा ट्वेल्व, फोर फोर ज़ा सिक्सटीन, फोर फाइव ज़ा ट्वेंटी. सिमिलरली यू विल टेक आउट द मल्टीपल्स. एंड देन मल्टीपल्स ऑफ सिक्स इज ऑल्सो सिमिलरली सिक्स. सिक्स टू ज़ा ट्वेल्व, सिक्स थ्री ज़ा एटीन, सिक्स फोर ज़ा ट्वेंटी फोर, सिक्स फाइव ज़ा थर्टी एंड सो ऑन. यू कैन टेक आउट डॉट डॉट मीन्स यू कैन टेक आउट एज मैनी मल्टीपल्स एज यू वॉन्ट. बट द थिंग इज हाउ मैनी मल्टीपल्स वी विल टेक आउट, इट्स डिपेंड ऑन यू ऑल्सो. बट एटलीस्ट वन और टू कॉमन मल्टीपल्स इफ यू विल फाइंड देन यू विल नो नीड टू टेक आउट द फर्दर मल्टीपल्स. लाइक हियर द इन सेकेंड स्टेप यू विल फाइंड द कॉमन मल्टीपल्स. इन कॉमन मल्टीपल्स फोर सिक्स एट ट्वेल्व वी कैन सी ट्वेल्व हियर ऑल्सो इन फोर मल्टीपल एंड इन सिक्स मल्टीपल. सो दिस इज द कॉमन मल्टीपल ऑफ ट्वेल्व. सेकेंड मल्टीपल वी कैन सी ट्वेंटी फोर हियर द सेकेंड इज ट्वेंटी फोर here is also 24. The second common multiple is 24. Similarly, you if you will take out the further multiples, the if you will find the multiples again, then you can find the common multiples here also. So basically we have find the two common multiples. Dot 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 shows means if you will go further to take out the multiples. We have taken out up to 4 8s are 32. If you will take out 4 9s are 36, 4 10s are 40, 4 11s are 44, 4 12s are 48. So you will again find the common multiples 48 here and then again. So if you will take out the further multiples, you can find the as many multiples. We have learned the properties of multiples also, that there are infinite multiples. So multiples we can find out infinite. Understood? So the question is how many multiples you will take out? As many as you can. If you find one common multiple in both, then also you can stop to take out the multiple, or one or two, depends on you. Here we have found two multiples, common multiples, 12 and 24. Now the third step is select the least common multiple. Least means the lowest. In 12 and 24, which is lowest? 12 is lowest, so 12 is the least common multiple. It means 12 will be the LCM of the 4 and 6. I hope you understood this. This is your exercise 20. Now question is 72 a multiple of 12? Is 95 a multiple of 19? Is 58 a multiple of 17? So, to show this, as we have shown about the factors, we will show here also about multiples. Means, you have to divide 72 by 12. If it will be completely divisible, then it will be the multiple of the given number. Like, first question, take 72 a multiple of 12. So divide 72 by 12. Divide 72 by 12. In 12 6 is 72. You can see 72 is completely divisible, leaving no remainder. It means it is completely divisible by 12. It means 72 is a multiple of 12. Similarly, you can find out others also. Understood? Now second question is write the first 10 multiples of 9. So to take out the multiples of 9, you have to write the tables. 9 1 is 9, 9 2 is 18, this is only the multiple. Similarly, write the first 9 multiples of 16, means you have to take out the multiples of 16. 16 1 is 16, first multiple. Then 16 2 is 32, second multiple. Similarly, you have to find up to 9. Okay. And here in question number 4, write the first 7 multiples of 23. It means you have to take out the multiples up to 7. Means 23 1 ja 23, 23 2 ja 46, 23 3 ja. Similarly, you will find out up to 7 multiples. Question number 5, examine whether 591 is a multiple of 7. So, to examine it, as we have examined here, is this is multiple of 12 or not, we will do here also, we will divide 591 by 7. If it will be divisible, then it will be the multiple, otherwise not. And here also show that 192 is a multiple of 6, show that 3016 is a multiple of 29, show that 10968 is not a multiple of 54. So to show this, you have to divide. If it will be completely divisible, then it will be multiple. If it will be not divisible, it will be not the multiple. I hope you all understood this. This is very easy exercise. Next exercise is 22. Find the prime factorization of each of the following numbers by building factor trees. So to find out the prime factorization of this, now to find the prime factorization of 48, first you have to know that what is prime number, that we have discussed already in part 1. See the part 1. 48. So first, to find the prime factorization of 48, the lowest prime factor we will take, and we will see whether it is divisible by 48, whether it's divide 48 or not. Let us see. The lowest prime factor is 2. So 2 is the factor of 48 or not. To see this, you have to divide 48. When you will divide 48 by 2, you will get 24. It means 48 is divisible by 2 by 24 times. And here you can see 2 is a prime factor. Now you have got 24. Now divide it into 2 branches and find out the next prime factor. Now tell me, 24 is divisible by 2 or not? It is divisible by 2. So take the lowest prime factor, that is 2, and it divides 24 how many times? 12 times. Now see the 12. 12 is a composite number. Composite numbers are further divisible. Okay. Now take out the prime factor of 12. Now 12 is divisible by 2 or no? It is divisible. How many times? 6 times. So 2, 6 is 12. Now 6. 6 is divisible by 2 or not? Further divide it. 6 2 times 2 multiply by 3. Now you can see at last we got 2 and 3. And 3 is also a prime factor. So the prime numbers are not further divisible. So we will stop here only. How many prime factors we got? 2, 2, 2, 2, and last one is 3. So the prime factors of 48 is equals to 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 3. How many times 2 come? You can see 1, 2, 3, and here 4. 4 times 2 is coming, and last one is 3. So we have taken out the prime factorization of 48. Now if you will take 63, so see, to find the 63 factorization, prime factorization of 63, let us take the smallest prime number, that is 2. Whether 63 is divisible by 2? No, it is not divisible by 2, because 63 is an odd number. Okay, so it is not divisible by 2. So means the 2 is not the factor of 63. Now take the next prime number. After 2, which prime number is coming? 3. So see whether 63 is divisible by 3 or not. It is divisible. How many times? 21 times. So we have found one prime factor of 63, that is 3. Now 21 is a composite number. Now again divide into two parts. 21. Now see, 21 is divisible by which prime number? It is not divisible by 2. because the lowest prime number is 2, it is not divisible by 2. We will come to the next prime number, that is 3. It is divisible by 3 how many times? 7 times. So 3 is a prime number. Here 7, you can see this is also a prime number. It means again it is not further divisible, because prime numbers are divisible by 1 and itself only. So if you got the prime numbers, you will, at last when you will get the prime number, you will not divide it further. So how many prime factorization you have got? How many prime factors? 3, 3 and 7. So the prime factorization of 63 is 3 multiply by 3 multiply by 7. Okay, this is the prime factorization of 63. Next is 78. If you have to find the prime factorization of 78, let us see. 78. Now see, the lowest prime number is 2. It is divisible by 2 how many times? 39 times. The first prime number is 2. Now this is a composite number, 39. Now see, 39 is divisible by 2 or not? It is not divisible by 2. So come to the next prime number, 3. It is divisible by 3 how many times? 13 times. So 3 is a prime number, and you can see 13 is also here a prime number. So we got at last prime number. Now it is not further divisible. It means this is only the prime factorization of 78. Now the factorization of 78 is, you can write 78 is equals to 2 multiply by 3 multiply by 13. See, when you are getting the factorization of, whenever you will multiply the numbers, you will get the 78. Like see, 2 3 is 6. When you will multiply 2 by 3, you will get 6, and 6 13 is 78. So whenever you are multiplying the numbers, check it after multiplying you are getting this number or not. So similarly, you can find out the other factors also. Now we will learn about the divisibility rules. Test of divisibility by 2. You can open your book. In your book it is given. Divisibility rule of 2. What is divisibility rule of 2 is? A given number is divisible by 2 if its unit digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. You can see, if in any number the unit digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 is given, then the number is divisible by 2. Very easy. In unit place you can see, if the unit place are given 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, then the number are divisible by 2. Here in example A, the unit digit you can see, it is given 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. It means these numbers are divisible by 2. If except this, if any number is coming in unit place, it means that they will be not divisible. You can see in example B, out of the numbers, these numbers, the unit place is 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. It means they are not divisible by 2. So divisibility rule, I hope you all understood of 2. Even numbers, you all know, if the number is divisible by 2, it means that is even number. If it is not divisible by 2, then it will be a odd number. Now come to the next rule, divisibility rule of 3. What is the divisibility rule of 3? A given number is divisible by 3 if the sum of its digit is divisible by 3. Means, take any number. Here example is 57,102. Let us take 57,102. So the divisibility rule of 3 is, the sum of its digit should be divisible by 3. Now its digit is 5. Add the digits of this number, 5 plus 7 plus 1 plus 0 plus 2. Add it, 5 plus 7 12 plus 1 13 and plus 0, it will give us again 13, and 13 plus 2 15. So the sum of the digits of the given number is 15, and the 15 is divisible by 3. It means the given number is divisible by 3. I hope you all understood this. Means, here you can see the addition of the given digit is 15, it means it is divisible by 3. The B part is given, 61,702. and the sum of its digit is coming 16. It means 16 is not divisible by 3. It means this number is also not divisible by 3. Next is divisibility rule of 5. It's very easy. If the unit digit is 0 or 5, then the number is divisible by 5. Whichever number, if the number is given this, if the unit digit is 5, it means this whole number is divisible by 5. So the divisibility of rule 5 is easy. Next is test of divisibility by 6. To find the divisibility rule of 6, you can see a given number is divisible by 6 if it is divisible by both 2 and 3. If the number is divisible by both 2 and 3. Now take example, 13,074. Now we will find whether it is divisible by 2 and 3 both or not. So to find the divisibility by 2, we can see the unit place is 4. It means it is divisible by 2. Now check the divisibility by 3, the sum of its digit. Find the sum of its digit. Here you can see in your book it is given, the sum of its digit is 15, coming 15. It means it is divisible by 3 also. It means this given number 13,074 is divisible by 2 also and 3 also. So the number is divisible by 6 also. Got it? The next example you can see, 47,061. Whether it is divisible by 2 or not? So the unit place is 1, it means it is not divisible by 2. And if it is not divisible by 2, it means it is not divisible by 6 also. Take the next number. Consider the number 53,204. So it is divisible by 2. Yes, because the unit place is 4, it means it is divisible by 2. Now, whether it is divisible by 3 or not, the sum of its digit is given 14. And 14 is not divisible by 3. It means this is not divisible by 3. It is divisible by 2, but it is not divisible by 3. And for divisibility rule of 6, it should be divisible by both 2 and 3. If it is not divisible by any of the 1, it means it is not divisible by 6. So in this B example, it is not divisible by 2, it means it is not divisible by 6. In C example, it is divisible by 2, but it is not divisible by 3. It means it is not divisible by 6. So we can understand for divisibility rule of 6, the number should be divisible by both 2 and 3. Next, the divisibility rule of 9. It is same as divisibility rule of 3. The divisibility rule of 3 is what? The sum of its digit should be divisible by 3. Here also, if the sum of its digit is divisible by 9, then the number is divisible by 9. Consider the example A, 14,607. The sum of its digit is given 18. It means 18 is divisible by 9. It means the number given 14,607 is also divisible by 9. Let us consider the B example, 32,604. The addition of means the sum of its digit is 15 and 15 is not divisible by 9. It means the 32,604 is also not divisible by 9. Now test of divisibility by 10. It's very easy. If the unit digit is 0, then the number is divisible by 10. You can see in A, all the unit places of the given numbers are 0. It means all the numbers are divisible by 10. In example B, you can see the unit places are not 0. It means they are not divisible by 10. I hope you all understood the divisibility rule easily. And similarly, as it is solved in examples, you have to solve your exercises also. You can see your exercise. Which of the following numbers are divisible by 2? So for divisibility rule, you already understood that if the unit digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, then the number is divisible by 2. You can see here 8 unit digit. It means it is divisible by 2. It is not divisible by 2. It is divisible by 2. It is divisible by 2. Here it is not divisible by 2. Why? Because the unit place is 1. Here it is divisible by 2 because the unit place is 2. Here it is not divisible by 2 because the unit place is 5. So this is not divisible. Here the unit place is 0. It means it is divisible by 2. So whichever places the unit, whichever the numbers in the unit place having 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, they are divisible by 2. Next is, which of the following numbers are divisible by 3? So for divisibility rule of 3, what you will do? Add the digits of the given number. Okay, 2382. Add it, the sum of 8, 2 plus 3 plus 8 plus 2. When you will add, you will get 15. It means 15 is divisible by 3. It means the number 2382 is also divisible by 3. Similarly, you can check other options also. Now, question number 3. Which of the following numbers are divisible by 6? For divisibility of 6, we have to find both 2 and 3. Means the number is divisible by 2 and 3 or not. So the first number, if you will take 7848, it is divisible by 2 because the unit place is 8. Now check the divisibility of 3 also. 7 plus 8 plus 4 plus 8. So 7 and 15, 4 19, and 19 and 8, 27. So it means the sum is coming 27, and 27 is divisible by 3. It means it is this number 7848 is divisible by both 2 and 3. It means it is divisible by 6 also. So as I have shown you in the example, it is shown. Similarly, you will show in your copy also. Next question is, which of the following numbers are divisible by 5? So we have learned about the divisibility rule of 5. If the unit place is 0 or 5, then the number is divisible by 5. You can see here in question number 4a, the unit place is 5, here 0, here 5, and here 0. These all a, c, f, and h are divisible by 5. Next question is 5. Which of the following numbers are divisible by 9? So the divisibility rule of 9 is what? The sum of its digits should be divisible by 9. So you can check each number after adding the digits. Whatever the sum will come, divide it by 9. If it will be divisible, then the number are divisible by 9. Next is question number 6. Which of the following numbers are divisible by 10? So very easy this one is. If the unit place is 0, see here A unit place is 0, in C unit place is 0, and in G unit place is 0, and in H also unit place is 0. It means these numbers are divisible by 10. And question number 7. Separate the even and odd numbers from the following. So whichever number is divisible by 2, that will be even, and whichever number will not divisible by 2, that will be odd. So divisibility rule we will check of 2. Unit place is 6 here, here 2, here 0, here 4, here 8. It means these all are divisible by 2. They are all even numbers and the rest of the numbers are odd numbers. I hope you all understood this, because for understanding this, you have to learn the divisibility rule. So learn the divisibility rule, then you will be able to understand this. So thank you all of you. I hope you all understood this chapter nicely, and practice it at your home in a rough copy work you will get on the link provided by the teacher in your WhatsApp group. So after that, you can complete your copy work. Thank you all.